Okay. In my previous three lectures, we talked about genes, and there is a force or energy which controls the genes, which activates the gene. And that energy is essentially coming from truth and the goodness and the beauty.
在我们的前三讲座里面，我们讲到了基因。那么控制基因的呢，是有一种力量的，使它有这个好的作用。那么使基因发生它的好的作用的呢，我们已经讲过了，是真、善和美。
Gene is a program which is installed in our cells.
基因实际上就是安装在我们细胞里的程序。
If gene changes.And our cell changes.
如果细胞里面的基因改变了，细胞也会改变。
And therefore, normal cells become abnormal cells.
这样，正常的细胞也就会变成不正常的细胞。
And when the cell become abnormal cell, we become sick.
当这些细胞成为不正常的细胞的时候，人就会生病。
And today, we scientists know that all diseases are due to the gene change.
今天科学家们已经认识到这一点，所有疾病的产生都是基因改变导致的。
For a long time, we doctors did not really know the diseases caused by gene changes.
在此之前的很长一段时间，没有医生明白原来导致疾病的原因是基因的改变。
But according to the Human Genome Project, now we know this, that all diseases caused by gene changes.
有了人类基因工程，我们今天明白了，是基因的改变使人生病。
I want to show you the picture of the gene map.
请大家看一下基因图。
In our cells, we have 23 chromosomes.
每一个细胞里面有23对染色体。
See, chromosomes are the clumps of the genes.
染色体是基因里的组成的。
So in one chromosome, there is several thousands of the genes.
在一个染色体里面会有成千上万的基因。
Okay, this is a gene map.
大家看到的这就是基因图。
And in the chromosome number one.
这是第一号染色体。
All different kinds of genes here.
看到了各种各样不同的基因。
Chromosome number one is the longest and tallest gene.
第一号染色体是最长的，也是最高的。大家看到。
If this gene in the chromosome number one it goes to abnormal gene.
如果这里的基因在第一号染色体里面出了问题
，then you have Alzheimer's disease.
那么这时候就会出现早老性痴呆症。
If this gene become abnormal,
如果这地方的基因变得不正常
you have a prostate cancer.
就会有这个胰腺癌。
And if this gene goes wrong,
大家看到了第二号染色体里的基因
you have colon cancer.
如果这出问题就会导致前列腺癌。
And with the chromosome number three,
大家看一下第三号染色体
if this genebecome abnormal gene,
如果在这里的基因出问题
then you have lung cancer.
就会导致肺癌。
There is a gene which controls your weight.
还有第七号基因它是控制你体重的。
On chromosome number seven,
第七号染色体。
If this gene goes wrong, you have obesity.
如果第七号染色体里的基因出了问题人就会变成肥胖的。
If this gene goes wrong,
还有这里的基因出问题会导致
diabetes,
糖尿病
yes, breast cancer,
还有这里是乳腺癌
and atherosclerosis,
这是动脉硬化
and leukemia,
还有白
pancreatic cancer,
这是什么癌症
breast cancer,
这里是乳腺癌。
All kind of diseases you know today, you know you call wealthy and rich disease.
今天的人们把这一类的疾病都称作富贵病。
And when people's lifestyle changes,
随着人们生活方式的改变
with very high content of fat and the protein,
所有摄入的食物都是高脂肪、高热量的这种食物。
And high content of sugar goes up, and then with the stress, you change your genes like this.
摄入过多的糖分，还有你这个紧张的情绪，都会导致疾病。
So, it is wonderful to know that, also surprising to know that our gene changes.
当我们了解到基因是可以改变的时候，这一发现令人吃惊。
And normal gene can change to abnormal gene.
正常的基因可以成为不正常的。
That's why we become sick.
这样我们就会生病。
But at the same time, this abnormal gene can come back to normal.
那么同样，这些不正常的基因也可以变回到正常的状态。
Therefore, all the diseases can be reversed.And recovered and curable.
如果是这样的话，所有的疾病都可以得到治疗，而且痊愈。
Why gene can change?
基因为什么会改变呢？
Because we scientists found out the structure of the gene is assembled structure.
因为我们发现到了基因的这个结构呢是组合式的结构。
The assembled structure can be, open, and we can replace the parts.
那么它就意味着我们可以打开基因，可以取代其中的某一个部分。
And they can be reassembled together.
然后再把它重新组装起来。
And this is very interesting discovery.
这一发现非常有意思。
That gene can change.
基因是可以改变的。
That's why when your mother had breast cancer.
这是为什么当你的母亲得了乳腺癌。
And if you are the daughter of that mother, you can have breast cancer.
那么得乳腺癌的妈妈的女儿也可能会患上乳腺癌。
But you have to make this point very clear again.
但是有一点大家一定要明白。
If you're born when your mother was very healthy with a normal gene in the breast.
在你妈妈非常健康、非常正常的时候生了你。
Then you haven't really received the breast cancer gene from your mother.
那么当母亲生你的时候，你并没有从她身体里遗传到改变的基因细胞。
Because the genes of your mother was normal then.
因为那时候母亲身体里的基因是正常的。
But few years later.
但是几年以后。
Your mother's breast gene has become changed to abnormal cancer gene.
在母亲乳腺细胞里面的基因开始改变，成为不正常的细胞。
Then your mother conceived you.
这时候妈妈如果怀孕了。
Then you may inherit that bad gene from mother.
那么这种情况下，那么你可能从母亲身体里遗传到这种基因变异的基因。
So, in this case, like you're born when your mother was 28 years old.
比如说妈妈生你的时候是二十八岁。
She was very healthy.
她很健康。
All the genes were normal.
所有的基因都是正常的。
Then you don't have to worry about.
所以这时候你不用担心。
But when your mother, finally had breast cancer diagnosed at the age of 60.
那么后来母亲六十岁的时候被诊断为有乳腺癌。
That means her gene changed to become abnormal gene, 10 years before.
那么实际上呢，是在十年以前，她的这个基因就已经变成不正常的了。
So when the mother was 50 years old.
那么就指的母亲五十岁的时候。
And then she didn't give any birth to any babies.
五十岁的时候，她也不再生育了。
Because all the children grown up.
孩子们都已经长大了。
She never got pregnant because she's after 50 now.
因为他已经年过五十，所以呢也就不再生育了。
Then all the daughters does not really have to worry about receiving bad gene from her mother.
那么他所生的女儿呢，也就不用再担心是从母亲身体里遗传到这种。
And there are many misunderstanding about genes.
但是呢，人们还是对基因有很多误解。
So, So now it is good to know that gene can change from normal to abnormal.
我们了解到基因可以从正常转变到不正常。
And from abnormal back to normal.
也可以由不正常的基因改变到起初正常的基因，这是一个好消息。
And genes are composed of four different chemical we call ATGC bases.
基因在它里面呢有四种不同的化学物质组成，我们把它称作 ATGC 碱基。
Let's take a look.
让我们看一下。
So the gene has two lines.
基因是由两条线组成。
And in between two lines.
在两条线之间。
The four different bases.
我们看到了四种不同的碱基。
If the sequence of these bases changes.
如果这个碱基的顺序改变了。
And then we become sick.
人们就会生病。
And we now found out the genes are the letters. These are the letters that the four sequence of bases are.
我们已经发现到了基因就像文字一样有它的特定的顺序。
And it is wonderful to know that the sequence of bases can change.
基因碱基的顺序可以改变，这是一个令人高兴的消息。
And let me show you a very interesting picture here.
大家看一下有一幅很有趣的图画。
Very interesting picture.
非常有意思，大家看一下。
Okay, here we go. Oops. Here's a cover of the Science News magazine.
大家现在看到的是科学消新闻的这个杂志。
Published in 1995, October 21st.
这一期呢是1995年10月21号出版的。
The picture's not that clear. It says changing sex in mid-ocean.
大家看到是在 mid-ocean 这个地方的这个性别的改变。
This is a picture of a male fish.
大家看一下哈，在海里面，你看到这条鱼是这个雌性的鱼。
This kind of male usually accompanies about 12 females.
This is male.哦，这是一个雄性的鱼，在它周围呢，通常是有十二条雌性的鱼。
And when scientists remove this male out of picture,
科学家们会把这条鱼拿走。
Then it was so surprising to see that one of those 12 female become male.
当他们拿走这条雄性的鱼之后，他们吃惊地发现到，原来十二条当中的雌性的鱼有一条会改变成为雄性。
Isn't that fascinating?
这个非常奇异。
And to change the sex.
改变了他的性别。
You need to change your gene.
是要改变你的基因的。
To change the gene, you need to be able to change the base sequences of the gene.
要改变基因，必须要改变它碱基的顺序。
So these fishes don't know what the genes are.
这些鱼是不明白基因的。
But this happens in the nature.
但是在大自然当中。这些现象却存在。
And gene changes.
基因在改变。
According to the need.
根据他们不同的需要，基因在改变。
And the definite need to make those ecological balances established.
在大自然当中有一种需要，就是维持生态平衡。
So scientists are proposing there is a force in the nature.
所以科学家们明白，在大自然界有一个力量。
That force must be very intelligent who knows the genes.
这个力量一定会非常有智慧，他知道。
It's controlling the sequence of the bases.
他还能够控制基因的顺序。
And knows how to change from the male fish into the female fish.
这个力量还明白，需要使雌性的基因改变成为雄性的。
Amazing discovery.
奇异的发现。
So there are.In this universe,
在这个宇宙当中
there are forces
的确有能力
to control the base sequence of the genes.
有一种能量是控制这个基因顺序的。
And many scientists call that cosmic consciousness or cosmic intelligence.
许多科学家把这种能量称作为宇宙智慧或者是宇宙。
Or maybe evolutionists might call that a natural selection force.
那么像进化论的学者把它称作自然选择力。
I don't think this is just a force law.
我不觉得它只是一个单纯的一个力量。
The force is also very intelligent.
它不仅仅是一种力量，它还有智慧。
The force already has that knowledge about genes.
而且这种力量它已经有了知识，基因的全部知识。
Anyway, genes are letters.
因为基因正像文字一样。
And that letters must be created.
文字是需要创造的。
Amazing discoveries we see.
奇异的发现。
So, it is important to understand there is a force in this nature.
我们需要了解到在大自然界有一个力量。
Which can control the base sequence of your genes.
这个力量是控制基因程序的。
You know,In China, there's a very interesting character, Qi.
在中国的汉字里面有一个字比较有意思，大家看一下，就是这个气。
Yeah, this is a force which gives us the life.
气呢，其实就是给我们生命的力量。
Amazing concept, right?
非常奇妙的概念，是不是？
There's a television set.
有这么一个电视机。
And there's two different television sets.
两种不同的电视机。
And let's say I asked this television set.
让我问这个其中的一个电视机。
What is your life?
我问这个电视机说什么是你的生命。
And this first television set says.
然后这个电视机说。
Life. That's a very interesting question.
他说，哎，你这个问题很有意思啊。
Well, I think that, you know, sometimes I wake up and begin to make some sounds.
我的生活是这样，我起来，然后出一些声音。
And on the screen, there's pictures moving.
在我的这个屏幕上会看到一些图片。
And I become warm and more hot.
那这时候呢，我会觉得很温暖。
Isn't this life I have?
这就是我的生命吗？
Well, what do you think about that, definition of the life?
电视机所给出来生命的定义，你觉得如何？
That's the same definition as many scientists define the life today.
许多科学家今天就是这样定义生命。
And many scientists say that life is a set of complex electrochemical reactions.
科学家们这样说，人的生命是不同的这个电反应组成的。
Life is reaction.
生命就是一种反应。
Reaction to what?
是对什么做出的反应呢？
That's qi, isn't it?
是气，对不对？
Yeah, life is complex electrochemical reaction by the qi.
是由于气所导致的不同的电化学的反应。
Qi comes in first.
首先是由气进来。
And then the qi begins all these complex electrochemical reactions in a body.
它推动了这些不同的电化学反应。
Well, let's look at ask this television set, the next television.
让我们问另一台电视机。
So I asked this different television set.
我问另一台电视机。
What do you think your life is?
你怎么定义你自己的生命呢？
And this television set is a little bit more clever than the first one.
这台电视机比前一台要聪明点。
And this guy says, Oh, I don't know exactly.
这个电视机他说啊，我还不十分了解。
Sometimes I'm cold.
有时候我是冷的。
Then suddenly I feel zonked.
可是我会突然之间觉得热一下。
Then I begin to sense that something comes into me.
我能够感觉到有什么东西进入到我里边。
Then I'm beginning to get warm.
我这时候会觉得温暖。
Then I begin to sound.
然后我会出声音。
And on my screen, the picture begin to move.
那么在我的这个荧幕上，大家会看到了这个图片。
I think I am reacting.
我觉得我是在做一种反应。
To that, to the something which came in from outside.
因为我感觉到有一种东西是从外界进入到我里边，我对它做出了反应。
I think that something which came into me from outside is life to me.
我能够感受得到，那从外界进入到我身体的力量就是生命。
What is that? Something came into television set.
那么进入到电视机，从外界进入到它里边的是什么呢
？Electricity.
电。
Yes.
是吗
？So electricity is life of the television set.
电就是电视机的生命。
Therefore, that chi is life of we human being.
对我们人类来讲，气就是我们的生命。
In our body, there's a complex electrochemical reaction is happening.
就是在我们人体当中不停地进行着电化学反应。
So, that reaction is simply reaction.
反应就是反应。
When there is a reaction,
当有反应发生的时候
there must be some energy has to come into the organism to begin set up the reaction.
那么什么导致这种反应的产生呢？是因为有外部的力量进入到你的化学组织里面。
So that energy which comes into human being，
就是那种力量进入到人体里
，and make us to be alive，
使我们开始有了生命。
And that is life to us，
这就是给我们的生命。
So I think qi is very very familiar to Chinese people。
我们中国人对气并不陌生。
But I'd like to ask you the question, what is qi?
那我要问问你了，到底什么是气呢？
What is the true nature of the qi?
什么是气的真相呢？真实的本性呢？
Do you know what is qi?
你知道吗？
Well, everybody said, qi is qi.
每个人都会想当然的说，气就是气。
Qi is qi.
气就是气呀。
And I cannot be satisfied with that.
我听到这个答案是不令人满意的。
I want to pursue that. What is the qi?
我还要追问下去，气到底是什么？
If you receive much qi,
当你身体里接受到很多气，
then you become very energetic.
你就会好像很活跃。
When?
什么时候你会活跃起来呢？
Let's look at into ourselves.
我们看一下人体的细胞图。
This is cell.
这是一个细胞。
Cell membrane.
细胞壁。
And this is nucleus of the cell.
看到的是细胞核。
In the nucleus, we have genes made of DNAs.
在细胞核里面有 DNA， 里面是基因。
And here we have a structure called look like this.
我们看一下这样的一个形状的东西。
And this we call mitochondria.
我们把它称作线粒体。
And this is mitochondria cut in half.
就是解剖开的线粒体。
You can see the inside of mitochondria.
线粒体里面就是这样的。
And what is this mitochondria?
线粒体是什么呢
？Like when you think about automobile.
你想想有一辆车。
The automobile requires fuel, gasoline.
你的车需要汽油。
And gasoline has to come, the fuel has to come into engine.
燃料这个汽油要进去，进到这个机器里面。
And then in the engine, the gasoline is being burned.
在你的这个发动机里，这个燃料要燃烧。
And when the gasoline is being burned, then the engine produce heat.
汽油燃烧的时候就会产生热量。
Power.
动力。
Yeah. And electricity.
它会有电能。
So we call it this heat and power, electricity, entire, we call them energy.
我们把这三样，动力、热量还有电称作能量。
And so,This mitochondria is engine of the cell.
线粒体就是细胞里的机器。
So a single cell It's just like an automobile.
其实细胞就像一个汽车。
See, so to have this fuel to be burnt in the engine.
要在这个发动机里燃烧能燃料。
We need fuel.
我们当然首先需要燃料。
But we also need oxygen, don't we?
我们还需要氧气。
See, that's why we breathe constantly.
所以就是我们不停地在呼吸。
You had your meal today.
你也吃过你的早饭。
And from your meal, from your food, you have sugar.
在你的食物里面有糖分。
The sugar is being provided and getting into the cell to the mitochondria.
糖分进入到细胞里，会进入到它的线粒体里面。
And also,the oxygen comes.
氧气也会进来。
And let me draw the picture for them.
大家看一下这个图片。
Okay. And here come.This is mitochondria. This is also mitochondria.
又一个线粒体。
No, there is. Draw a picture of the cell.
让我们看一下这个图片。
And this is nucleus.
这是细胞核。
And this is chromosome.
这是染色体。
With many different genes inside.
在染色体里面有不同的基因。
And here we have a mitochondria.
在这里是线粒体。
Into this mitochondria we have a sugar.
糖分会进入到线粒体里。
And into the mitochondria, we have to have oxygen coming.
还有进来的还有氧气。
Then we need to have this qi coming.
然后我们就需要这个气。
And then we produce the heat.
然后就有热量出来。
And the power.
动力。
And electricity.
电。
All these we call together energy.
这三样呢，就是我们平常所说的能量。
And this qi also activates genes.
气呢也会对这个基因有直接的作用。
So, if you receive this qi,
当我们接受到这个气的
时候 very actively,
会变得非常活跃。
Then you produce large energy.
然后你就会产生大的能
量。And you become very hungry very fast.
你很容易很快就饿肚子。
Okay, but. When that happens?
那什么时候
这样? When you're very happy, right?
然后你会
you had a good news.
啊，你听到好消息，你会觉得开心。
Wow! I passed my exam.
啊，我考试及格了，太棒了。
Yes, and I finally got my scholarship.
啊，我终于拿到了我奖学金。
Yes. Then, you have no more indigestion.
这时候你会有正常的这个消化。
消化不良，身体不怎么样。So you digest your food very fast.
你很容易消化你体内的食物。
And you burn your sugar, and you have a wow, you have a good power.
糖分一燃烧，你就有力气。
So qi becomes stronger when you have a good news.
当你听到好消息的时候，气在你体内就会变得强大起来。
When you're happy,
你就会怪变得开心起来。
So we must understand that this.True nature of qi.
这就是气的本来的特征。
Yeah. And so when you have the truth, you finally understood something. Yes, now I understand.
当你最终认识到了真理，你会说，哎呀，我终于明白了这一切。
Then you have more energy, right?
然后这时候你的体内产生出更多的能量。
So one of the nature of the truth, qi is the truth.
气的本质就是真理。
Then somebody did something so good to you.
当别人对你是那样的好。
And you say thank you, thank you.
你说哎呀多谢多谢。
Oh, I'm so happy that he helped me.
哎呀，他帮助了我，真是太好了。
Now the problem is solved.
问题不存在了。
Oh, I'm so happy.
太高兴了。
Of course, then you become hungry because you know you digest the food and you burn energy.
这时候你觉得那么高兴，结果肚子就饿了，很容易消化食物。
And you'll be so happy because your endorphin gene is activated.
你是那样的开心，正是因为你身体里的 endorphin 产生了它起的作用。
So it is qi activate genes.
是气对基因产生了作用。
It is qi, qi.Produce energies in the mitochondria.
产生了能量。
Yeah. And so it is wonderful to know what the qi exactly is.
所以大家一定要明白什么是气，它是这样的好消息。
So let me go through the nature of the qi.
让我们再看一下气的这个本质。
And qi, nature of qi is truth.
是真理。
Goodness.
良善
and beauty
美
wow so beautiful
太美了、yeah.
see when you met your wife
当你第一次见到你的妻子
you felt she's so beautiful
啊你觉得她太漂亮了
did you get depressed or did you get happy
你是见到她你是不高兴还是高兴呢
of course you were happy
高兴坏了哈
your endorphin gene was activated
你的 endorphin 不停地在活动
the beautyActivate your genes.
是美刺激了你身体里的基因。
And beauty is the qi, the power.
那美就是这气，
And
这动力。
Yeah, which can burn the sugar in the mitochondria.
然后使线粒体里面的这个糖分充分燃烧。
It is just like an automobile.
还像汽车一样。
See?
我们还拿汽车做比喻。
Like your car is parked outside.
门外停了你的一辆车。
Where in the car, in the engine of your car,
在你汽车的发动机里。
There are some gasoline in the engine, right?
在汽车里面有汽油。
And there's oxygen in the engine.
里面有氧气。
Is that gasoline in the engine burns right now?
那么当时这个停着的汽车，它燃烧了它的这个燃料吗
？No.
没有。
You have to go and get into the car and take out your keys and you have to start the car.
然后这时候你要进到车里拿出车钥匙启动一下。
Yeah, when you start the car.
当你去启动车的时候。
And what happens in the engine?
然后你车里的发动机会怎么样呢
?And there's an electric spark.
这时候会有一下子电击它一下一个火花。
Spark.
是火花。
See? And if you drive for 2 hours continuously,
你连续开车两个小时之后,
there's a continual supply of the spark.
会不停地有这个气供应给这个发动机。
If you turn off the key, ignition,
如果你把这个汽车的钥匙拔下来,
spark stops.
没有了这个火花。
And car stops.
汽车也就停了下来。
There's no more qi for the car.
这个汽车没有了气了。
So qi for the car is spark.
那么其实对于汽车来说，这个气就是它的火花。
What What is spark for us?
那我们身体里的火花是什么呢？
And that is qi for us.
就是气。
See, that qi is controlling the genes.
就是这个气控制着人体的基因。
Because of that existence of the qi in the universe.
就是宇宙当中存在着这样的一个气。
That's why we're living.
所以我们活着。
I think Chinese philosophy is a very wonderful philosophy.
中国的哲学我觉得是非常奇妙的。
But qi goes up when you love one another.
当我们彼此相爱的时候就有了气。
See, when you open the love, then you see inside love there is truth, goodness, and beauty.
其实你打开爱看一看里面就是真理良善和美。
You know, love must be truthful.
爱必须是忠诚的真实的。
Love must be good.
爱必须是良善
的。And beautiful.
爱必须是美好的。
And also, when you have hope,
当你有希望的时候
your qi goes up.
你的气也出来了。
Yes, now I have hope.
然后你会大声喊着说我有希望了。
Then you become hopeless.
那么当你觉得很灰心的时候
qi goes down.
气也没有了。
No more endorphin production.
也没有了 endorphin 让你觉得高兴。
Endorphin producing gene become depressed.
产生 endorphin 的基因现在变得非常的郁闷。
So you're depressed.
你自己也觉得郁闷。
You don't produce much energy.
你身体里也没有什么能量。
That's why even though you eat some food,
如果这时候你吃东西
it doesn't go through, it doesn't get digested.
这样的食物 也消化不了。
See, all your health is depend upon how much qi you receive.
所以其实你的健康是取决于你到底有多少的气。
How much qi you receive is depend upon how much you love.
那你身体里得到多少的气呢？要看你有付出多少的爱。
How much you find the truth in your life.
在你的生命里你找到了多少的真理。
How much you've been being so good to other people.
你对别人是怎么样的？
And how beautiful you think the life is.
你去怎么样看待你的生活是美好的吗？
How beautiful you have your family together.
你跟家人在一起的时候是那样的美好吗？
How beautiful to have your wonderful family loving one another.
而当你家庭里面的家庭成员彼此相爱的时候是多么美好。
So that's the essence of life.
这就是生命的精华。
Essence of the qi.
这也是气的真意。
So this qi is working on the fishes.
这个气呢，对这个鱼也起作用。
To change the genes and make a male fish into female fish.
所以它会把这个雌性的鱼改变成了雄性的鱼。
To balance the ecological balances.
生态平衡得到了维持。
To make this world to be able to go on.
使这个世界得以延续下去。
And this qi is actually very intelligent to be able to control and maintain ecological balances.
这种能够维持生态平衡的气一定是非常有智慧的。
I think that same qi is maintaining ecological balances within our body too.
而且这个气它也维持着我们身体内的生态平衡。
So I don't know how to control my genes.
我自己控制不了我的基因。
I cannot provide the qi to myself.
我自己也不能够使我身体里产生这样的气。
I have to receive the qi.
气必须是从体外得到的。Okay.
When I went to beautiful place, beautiful mountains.
当我去到这个美好的地方，看到那美丽的风景。
Well, I went to Changbek Shan.
我去了长白山这个地方。
I went up and saw the Chenji. You know,
天池。
天池。
看到了长白山的天池。
I saw beautiful. Wow.
还有这么美的地方。
有 many people who went together with me.
跟我同去的有很多人。
And many other people who didn't even know me.
那些人也不认识我。
Everybody said, "Wow, wonderful."
每个人都说，哎呀，真美。
Beautiful.
这么美。
See, So when you sense the beauty,
当你感受到美的时候，
气过去，
就产生了气。
So qi is working on us, and qi is also working on the fishes.
气呢对我们产生作用，也对鱼产生同样的作用。
And even changes the sexes, you know.
它甚至能够改变这个鱼的性别。
Well, yesterday we on my previous lecture you saw that when a mother squirrel have babies.
昨天你看到了一个这个土拨鼠，它怀孕的时候。
Even the poisonous snake comes and bit them, and she doesn't die.
当小尾蛇的蛇毒进入到它的体内的时候，它活了下来。
Because this mother squirrel is producing a new substance which neutralizes poison.
因为在怀孕期的土拨鼠妈妈，她身体里会产生一种物质来解毒。
Because those new genes is activated.
因为是新的基因产生了发生的作用。
Well, scientists did not know that the squirrels have that genes.
科学家们并不知道土拨鼠有这样的基因。
But now we scientists know.
现在。我们科学家了解到了
There's a force came into the squirrel.
是有一种能力进入到土拨鼠的里边。
The qi came into the fishes.
气呢进入到鱼的身体里。
And qi come into us.
气也进入到了我们的身体里。
And control our genes.
控制着我们体内的基因。
And that's why we are alive.
所以我们因此活着。
See,Qi is not just restricted to the living creature alone.
所以不仅仅是这个我们生活的这个自然环境在控制基因。
In the physical world,
在这个物质世界里。
See,let me show you this.
大家看一看这个图片。
You know the atom. Atom. Wonder.
大家看一看，这是原子。
Everything is made up with the atom.
这是原子。
So when you take a little teeny piece out of this coffee cup.
那我们看一下这个杯子。
And we see the atom.
我们看到了原子。
And the atom is consists of the nucleus.
原子组成了这个核
，and electrons circling around the nucleus.
那么在原子核周围是有电子。
And the next picture here, this is a nucleus here.
大家看到了原子核。
And there are many electrons circling around.
它周围运行着很多的电子。
If we magnify this nucleus,
我们把这个原子核放大一下，大家看一下。
And inside nucleus, there are two different kind of particles.
是有两种成分
the proton, the pink,
大家看到这个粉红色的
the yellow particle,
还有黄色的这个
neutral,
是被称作中子红色的呢是质子
You know, this is, you are looking at the miracle right now.
你现在看的是这个
well, Why this is so miraculous?
为什么这是一个奇迹呢
Because
大家看到
you are looking at something impossible.
因为你看到是不可能的一件事情。
This is normally this impossible thing is happening right now here.
其实这个不可能的事情正在发生，奇迹般的发生了。
In your body right now, the same thing is happening.
就在你的人体里也发生着这样的奇迹。
A body is made of all the atoms too.
我们身体也是由原子组成的。
You know, carbon atoms.
你知道碳原子。
And hydrogen.
还有氢原子
oxygen,
氧原子
nitrogen,
还有 electrogen 原子
That's about it, as you saw. And all these atoms have these protons and neutrons.
这些原子都是由质子和中子组成的
Now the protons, this pink particle, are charged.
大家注意到这个粉红色的质子
The chargedPositive.
它们通常是起这个正极的作用。正极。 正性粒子的作用。
Yeah. And when you have two positively charged particles come closer and closer,
当两个正性的质子靠近的时候，
then what happens?
会怎么样呢？
Well, they repel, they push away.
他们互相排斥。
But when it comes very close,
当他们靠得非常近的时候，
the power which push away each other becomes so great.
使他们互相排斥的力量变得非常大。
So that's why this is a miracle right now.
所以这是非常大的一个神迹。
So what I'm trying to tell you right now is,
我想告诉大家的是什么呢？
Even though you are not feeling them,
你即使没有感受到这一点，
Even though you can, it's not visible,
甚至你看不到这一点，
There's an invisible power.
其实有一种看不到的力量。
Is trying to put this together.
就要把这个质子放在一起。
That's why these atoms are not exploding away.
所以这些原子没有爆炸跑开。
Isn't that miraculous?
这不是神迹吗？
So this kind of force, extremely strong force.
这就是它强作用力和。
Scientists call nuclear strong force.
科学家把这种强作用力称作为核强力。
If this force disappears suddenly,
如果这个核强力突然消失掉，
all of us disappear suddenly.
我们会突然间从这个地球上消失掉。
All of us become proton and neutron.
我们都会变成质子和中子分解掉。
And all these neutrons, they explode too.
中子也会爆炸。
And they become quark.
他们就变成了不同的夸克。
So look, this is neutron.There are three quarks. This is a proton, have three quarks.
质子也有三个夸克组成。
So, to put these three quarks together,
要把这三个夸克放在一起。
And it also requires energy.
也需要一种能量。
There's in this universe, it is formed by invisible force.
实际上在这宇宙当中使它存在的是一种我们看不到的力。
What do you call that we can walk on the earth without flying away?
我们为什么能够走在地上没飞上天呢？
Gravity,
是重力、
right?
对不对？吸引力、
yes.
对不对？
We jump.
我们跳得高一点。
But we never fly away.
还是飞不走。
We come right back onto the earth.
我们跳起来又回来。
There's a force putting us onto the earth.
是因为这种力量使得我们回到地面。
We call it gravity.
我们把它称作重力引力。
You know Isaac Newton?
大家知道牛顿吗？
The British physicist.
英国的物理学家。
Who found gravity?
他发现了万有引力。
You know, he was lying on the field.
他躺在这个草地上。
There was an apple tree.
然后看到一棵苹果树。他看到苹果掉下来。
Well, ordinarily, everybody would think, oh, maybe that apple is ripe.
通常情况下，人们会想这个苹果熟了，所以落地了。
But Newton said.
但牛顿想的不一样。
Why it drops?
苹果怎么会掉下来？
So there must be some force. The earth is pulling this apple down.
他想。地上一定有一种力量使得苹果落下来。
Yeah, his thinking is right, you know.
他知道，你知道吗？他是对的。
Like in the space,
在宇宙当中，在宇宙空间当中。
Where there's no gravity.
当没有引力的时候。
You don't drop.
你根本不会往下。
You float, huh?
然后你是漂浮状态的。
So if there is no gravity,
如果没有重力和
apple should never be dropped on the ground.
苹果不会掉下来的。
Apple should be floating.
苹果会漂浮的。
See? So Newton is right.
所以牛顿是正确的。
So Newton thought, wow, there is force.
牛顿看到了一种力量。
Which makes every one of us and everything to be on the ground.
这种力量使得每一个人、每一样物体都在地上。
Wow! So, I think Newton went to his friend.
所以我想，这时候牛顿会告诉他的朋友。
You know why the apple drops down onto the ground?
他大声对他朋友说：“你知道苹果为什么会落下来吗？”
And friend said, Are you crazy?
朋友会说你是不是疯掉了？
女主持 I'm not crazy.
牛顿肯定说我没有疯，疯的不是我。
There's a force which is pulling the apple down to the ground.
的确应该有一种力使苹果落下来。
Old Francis, you are crazy.
这时候朋友不得不说你真的疯了，牛顿。
Who is right?
到底谁是正确的呢？
Newton is right.
是牛顿。
And Newton was very happy.
牛顿真的很
快乐。Newton discovered existence of the force in this universe.
牛顿发现了存在在这个宇宙当中的一种力量。
气 does this also.
气也是这样。
See, 气 does this also.
气的作用也是这样。
气 does all the miracles.
是气产生了这一切的神迹。
气 make you feel happy by activating genes.
是气到了你的人体里，你会觉得开心。
Producing endorphins.
产生了 endorphin.
And 气 produce energies in your mitochondria.
那么在线粒体里，气也产生了能量。
气 does everything.
是气。作用在这一切的上面。
And what is the nature of the qi?
那么什么是气的本质呢？
That's truth.
是真理。
Goodness.
良善。
And beauty.
美。
And trust.
信靠。
When you can trust.
当你真的可以有信心的时候。
And you have hope.
当你有盼望的时候。
Then you have love.
当你有爱的时候。
You have the qi.
你就会有了气。
See, I think qi is love.
气就是爱。
Why? In the love, there is a truth, goodness, and beauty.
因为在爱里边是有真理、良善、美好组成。
In the love, we can trust.
因为爱，所以我们可以信靠。
In the love, we have hope.
因为爱，才有了盼望。
And qi is very intelligent.
气是这样有智慧的。
Qi is very powerful.
气又是这样有能力的。
And that qi is love.
气就是爱。
When you have love, everything becomes meaningful.
当你对这个世界有爱的时候，一切都有了它的意义。
When there's love, you have the truth about everything.
当你有爱的时候，你会找到真理。
When there's no love,
没有爱呢？
As I mentioned in my previous lecture.
在前面的讲座里面。
Nothing become meaningful.
一切都失去了它的意义。
See, I'm originally Korean.
我是韩国人。
And you know, year 2002 and the World Cup.
大家还记得2002年的世界杯吗？
See, if I did not love my country Korea.
我其实是爱我的国家。
Even though.The Korea beat Spain or Italy.
在这场比赛当中
probably I just said, well, they did pretty good.
嗯，看到自己国家打得不错，觉得行。
Why? Because if I don't love my nation, my mother nation,
如果我不爱国家
nothing is meaningful.
那就失去了意义。
So they won.The football game does not mean anything to me.
国家到底是赢了是输了也失去了意义。
So it cannot become qi to me.
所以这一切不会成为气进入到我的身体里。
I'm not happy.
我不会觉得开心啊。
It doesn't really affect my mitochondria to produce more energy.
我的线粒体也不会对此做出反应。
But since I love my country.
但是因为我爱我的国家。
Every game they won.
只要我的国家赢了。
Yes. I have a lot of qi.
然后你就会有产生出很多的气。
So qi is love.
气就是爱。
Love makes everything. Love makes fact into truth.
是爱使你眼睛所看到的事实有了真理。
And our genes respond to the truth.
而气呢，就是对这个基因起作用，而基因对真理有它的反应。
I wish that you have a cheerful day.
我希望你们有气。
With a lot of qi.
很多的气。
And be healthy today.
然后今天是健康的。
See you next time.
好，大家下次见。